When you're doing a modal analysis, the MLMM, maximum likelihood estimation of a modal model add-in for test lab modal, lets you improve curve fits. Let's take this example. Here I have a convertible, fully trimmed vehicle. I'm going to do a stabilization diagram where I can select poles that represent the modes of my structure. And now I'm going to calculate the shapes. You can see there I have some rigid body modes. I have some flexible modes of the engine, steering wheel modes, etc. One way I would validate my model is I would go to modal synthesis here and take a look at the results. And you can see that in some cases where the FRF, which is measured in red here, is heavily damped, the green FRF, which is calculated from my estimates, doesn't quite match up FRF-wise. In fact, I have 35% correlation, meaning the shapes of the green and the red curve are 35% alike, and amplitude-wise, they are off by up to 65%. If I go back to my modal curve fitter, pick MLMM, I can have it iterate through 20 times. I'll hit calculate here. The difference between the calculated FRF and the measured FRF is becoming less and less. It's almost at the end. We have 20 iterations. That means it's changing the frequency and the damping and the modal participation factors ever so slightly 20 different times to try and make the FRFs match better. And when it's done, I will have a new set of modes. And my new set, if I go back here to the modal synthesis, notice it's a lot better. If I was to switch between the old and the new, originally I was 35%, 65% error. Now I have 88% correlation, 11% error. And that's the MLMM.